Welcome back to the SPF Top 5 Plays of the Week for Week 2 of Season 3. New and exciting strategies bubbled to the surface this week as our coaches get more familiar with the low-tier format and call on underused members of their squads to step up big time in these epic Top 5 plays. At number 5, the Lilac City Luckers came out of their shell in their match against Rydon D's Nuts this week to smashing success. In Game 1, Minior faced down Blastoise under Trick Room, with both Pokémon sporting massive stat boosts thanks to Shell Smash, but managed to go first thanks to Minior's Meteor form, making it slower. But in Game 2, a clutch survival from Ampardos' Iron Head left Minior in Shields Down mode, meaning it could now outspeed Blastoise despite mirrored stats once again, picking up a massive KO with Acrobatics through Reflect and emphatically closing out the series. At number 4, the Onceapeps brought an out-of-the-box strategy against the Balunlee Barbies in Game 1 that had an unexpected upside. After setting Trick Room on Turn 1, Stantler went for a skill swap as Empoleon switched in beside it, aiming to activate Intimidate against its own partner for a competitive boost. In a stroke of luck or genius, skill swap also caught the incoming Pikachu, giving Stantler the Lightning Rod ability, not only boosting Empoleon, but protecting it from electric-type attacks as well. The offense boost combined with Stantler's defensive prowess would prove too much to overcome for the Barbies, locking in a win for the Peps in Week 2 of the season. In Game 3 of a hard-fought series between Ledian's Lucky Lads and the Laguna Lagging Tails, Life Orb Bisharp faced down Greninja and Braviary with Clefable's support, ready to clean up some KOs and put away the series for the Lucky Lads. However, the Lagging Tails proved they wouldn't be suckered into an easy loss, relying on Greninja's Water Shuriken and Braviary's non-attacking moves to stay safe from Sucker Punch, causing it to fail 3 times in a row while Loaded Dice racked up damage and steering the momentum back to the Lagging Tails in this tense match decider. At number 2, the Zangoose Zinners put on a show in their first game against the Molten Feather Berserkers that left all concert goers 6 feet under. With a classic combination of Parish Song and Shadow Tag, along with judicious use of Encore, Disable, and Fake Out, Screamtail and Gotharita teamed up to take down Furret and Pheasantipity with the power of Song. The dynamic duo would appear again for a repeat performance later in the match, taking advantage of the captive audience and slamming home 4 Parish Song knockouts in a curtain-dropping match win. And finally, the hard-fought match between the BC Beyond and the Wet Ash Blissies brings us to our number 1 play of the week this week in an impressive upset victory. Following a Game 1 loss to Duraludon, Coach Halle Berry dug in deep, focusing down the other members of the team and maneuvering an endgame with only Mimikyu and Duraludon left alive, forcing the reveal of Body Press as the only damaging move. With a path to victory clear, Game 3 was a repeat, with Mimikyu dropping all the way down to 4% HP before finishing the sweep, leaving it alone with Duraludon once again and forcing the Beyond to throw in the towel in an incredibly close 3-game series. Thanks for watching the SPF Top 5 Plays of the Week. What was your favorite play this week? Let me know in the comments down below, and don't forget to subscribe to catch all the action as we continue with the regular season.